Yeah, so in order for FP&A to partner with business stakeholders, we have to look at the activities that we do today and think about how can we do different in the future. Because the reality is that today, FP&A professionals spend too much time working with data, reports, and analysis, which are things that they can do on their own behind their screen without talking to anyone. What they need to do instead is they need to look at their analysis and figure out what can I find from this which can help my business stakeholders make better decisions. Then they go talk to them and share those insights with them, make a recommendation for what should they actually do, and then together with the business stakeholders, they make the decision, implement the solution, and then they get the value. So it's a lot more about sharing insights, influencing decisions, and together executing on what you agree. And so if a business unit develops capabilities on their own, because maybe FP&A hasn't stepped into this space, there can be a conflict. But really, they only do that if FP&A is not taking on the role on themselves. So really, it's for FP&A to step up and actually do what they're supposed to do. And then the business units will happily take FP&A's lead to get more analytical capabilities and get more insights, because it will help them make better decisions and eventually get better business results. Yeah, so in terms of organizational structure, you can go many different ways. It's more about what capabilities do you have to actually partner with the business, right? So as an FP&A function, yes, you still need to work with data, reports, and analysis, because that's the foundation of what you do. So you could imagine a situation where you have like a center of excellence within the data, reports, and analysis, and then you have FP&A professionals closer to business units that are then out there talking to the business stakeholders every day, looking at the analysis, taking out the insights, and together making better decisions.
FP&A typically is producing numbers, sending them out, you know, making analysis. But, you know, if you want to be business partner, you need to get close to the business. And two fundamental things: you need to change conversations and change decisions. I think FP&A and the finance business partners, they are really two best buddies in crime here, because FP&A often sits centrally and can provide a lot of the data platform, the analysis platform, whereas the business partner sits close to the business and should be using that insight, that information management tool, to actually go and change conversations, change decisions together with the business. So finance business partners actually have great opportunities to create value. I think you can do it in three different ways. So first, look at how you are running your business. If you look through the value chain of the company, every single component of that is opportunities for you to go in and make interventions as a business partner to change decisions, change conversations, and make more money. So first, being the running the business, the value chain. Secondly, you can also go in on changing the business. So this is where strategic initiatives, must win battles or whatever is part of the strategy. Those are opportunities also for a business partner actually to come in and help, you know, look at different opportunities and scenarios. And thirdly, you should look at measuring the business. So can you put a value tree across the business and see where's value created, where's value destroyed? All of those are opportunities for finance business partners in, you know, running the business, changing the business, measuring the business. So we typically put the activities for a finance business partner into six buckets. First one being data, reporting, analysis. Those are the first three. And then you should, you know, once you have prepared your analysis, you should put that into insights. So creating insights to the business, then trying to influence the business and ultimately impact the business. So you go from making recommendations to making sure those recommendations are actually being decided. And when they're decided, you make sure that value is created. You can measure the effect of that decision. So the last three are typically where you create the most value. The first three, it's about spending the least time on as a business partner. So we often see that it's unfortunately the other way around. People spend most time on getting the data, controlling it, you know, generating the report, distributing them, and making the analysis, and not enough time on creating insights, influencing for decisions, and creating impact.